A very good morning to one and all present here. My name is Shishti Prashad and I'll be your host for today's event. Enduring the journey of enriching knowledge, I welcome you all to the third episode of our alumni talk series, Vim Rishyotsav, an erudite festival of discussion organized by Anuvrat, the Departmental Club of Electronics and Communication Engineering. I am profusely elated to take an opportunity to welcome an eminent personality among us in the form of today's alumni speaker, Mr. Paras Ram Meena, the man of distinct and a fountainhead of illuminating ideas, an idol of knowledge and experience, and inspiration to all of us. Sir completed his graduation from National Institute of Technology Sikkim in the year 2015. After that, pouring in management from Indian Institute of Chupali at TVS Motors, sir is presently appointed as an assistant manager in the esteemed Hindustan Petroleum Corporation Limited. What inspires me the most to talk about him is his academic achievement. He attained the astonishing accomplishment of securing second rank in the entire department while belonging to top 10% of all students. He was also an executive member of the TNP cell, NIT Sikkim. He was also one of the founding members of EC Societies Anuvrat, where he acted at venerable positions of representative and secretary. He has also been a member of Matrix Club at IIM Trichy. Today, he is presenting insightful thoughts on topics like capital market, financial system, CAT exam, and possible career opportunities after MBA. So, without any further ado, please join me in welcoming Mr. Paras Ram Meena and let's hear him share his experience and knowledge with us. Sir, the platform is all yours.
Yeah, hi. Good morning, everyone. So, I hope you all are doing well. So, at the very outset, I would like to express my heartiest thanks to NIT Sikkim family, especially to Anuvrat team, Hemant Kathania sir, and Surajit Kundu sir for having me here. I am extremely delighted to join with you. Thank you very much. So today I have given a task to give a presentation on any topic. So I have selected a topic called capital markets. Actually, I have completed my MBA in finance also. So that's why I have selected this topic and I hope you will enjoy this topic as well. So before presenting, let me present first. Are you able to see it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, before starting my presentation, I would like to give my introduction first. So, in 2015, I graduated in Electronics and Communication Engineering from NIT Sikkim. That my introduction is already given by Anjali. But let me explain it once again. So I got a departmental rank second, and then in final year I was a former secretary. Hello, are you able to see it?
So sir, the presentation is not visible to us.
Oh, just a second. So how to share it? I'm not able to get it.
Sir, in the Google Meet window, there must be an option present now in the right-hand side.
So it's showing answers Sony is presenting.
Arjun, would you stop presenting, please?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir, now it would be there.
Now, are you able to see it?
Yes, sir, it is visible.
Just a second. But I am not able to see my presentation now.
So you can switch to the presentation screen in your laptop. We are able to see it.
So you guys are now able to see it.
Yes, sir. The first slide is here.
Introduction, right?
Yes, sir.
But how can I see it in that presenting tab?
Sir, as you have, you would have opened this presentation tab and you are presenting it in the Meet. So you can go back to the tab and you can see your presentation over there.
Now it's coming?
Yes, sir, it is visible.
Now it's coming, right?
Yes, sir. So you can switch to this slideshow, then we can have it on the full screen.
Now it's coming, right?
Yes, sir, it is visible.
Okay, let me begin now. So before starting my presentation, I would like to give my introduction first, which has already been given by Anjali. So I graduated in Electronics and Communication in 2015. And I got departmental rank second. And in final year, I was a secretary of Anuvrat. And before that, in third year, I was selected as a representative in Anuvrat. And before that, in third year and second years, whenever I got a chance to go on vacations to my home, then I did four internships. First was on satellite image processing at ISRO, and then on microcontroller in DRDO, and then I have completed hacking and robotics course at IIT Kharagpur. And finally, I did my internship on frame control of Mac layer for BAN applications at IIT Guwahati. So I'll suggest students to do at least two internships during your vacations. So because it will be very beneficial at the time of placements. So I'll suggest that. And after that, in 2015, actually I gave an exam of CDS and then I got selected in Indian Army in my first attempt. So I'll show you the picture of my selection. So this is the picture of my selection. I am wearing shirt number 12 and total 28 students were selected in the Indian Army in 2015. So I was one of them. And simultaneously, I gave the exam of CAT also. So in first attempt, I also cracked CAT. So I will tell you why I preferred CAT over GATE. So that will come at later part of time. And in 2015, then I joined IIM Trichy. Then the most difficult task was to select the subject. So I preferred for marketing actually. So then I completed for my post graduation in marketing from IIM Trichy from 2015 to 17. It was a really a difficult journey for me to switch from engineering background to marketing background. Then in 2016, I got selected in HPCL. and currently I am working in HPCL as assistant sales manager at Jaipur regional office. Currently I am handling 9 districts of Rajasthan, and I am head of those districts, and I am handling this sales area from last 3 years. So it's really a good experience working at Hindustan Petroleum. And then last year I thought I am wasting my time. Since last 3 years I have not gained any degree, so I thought now I should pursue some degree. So last year I enrolled for a MA program in political science from IGNOU. It's a distance learning course. So currently I am pursuing a MA in political science from IGNOU. And these were the academic part. Now I will tell you my extracurricular part, which I have done in my college time and my school time and during IIM. So I have played a national level cricket in 2009 from KVS. It was an interesting journey. And simultaneously, you know, I was enrolled in Scouts and Guides also. So in 2010, I received a Rashtrapati Award in Scouts and Guides. And then when I joined this IIM, then we participated in a business plan competition conducted by IIM Raipur, and we won Samadhan 2015. So that was the name of actually business plan competition. And then we got a prize of rupees 2 lakh in that competition. So these were the major extracurricular activities which I've done till now. So this was my brief introduction, which was already given by Anjali. Now, before starting my presentation, let me ask you some questions actually. So have you heard of these words? These words usually come in newspaper, and you oftenly hear these words like company, shares, dividend, IPO, investors. So guys, have you heard of these words?
Yes, sir, we have heard. Yeah. Sir, would you please switch on to the particular slide, because we are able to see only the first slide over the screen.
Yeah, but I have switched to that slide also.
Sir, once select the slide number 3, which you are talking about.
Now?
Yes, it is visible now.
Okay. So it's coming on full screen, right?
Yes, sir, it is.
Okay. So have you heard of these words? Huh? Company, shares, dividend, IPO, investors, DMAT account, NSE, BSE, SEBI, then bull, bear. You must have heard about these words. Actually, these words comes oftenly in newspaper, and you know, these are related to our courses also. So before starting my presentation, let me ask you a simple question. When we want to start a new business, which is the first thing which comes in our mind? Can anyone tell me?
Idea.
Yeah, idea is a part, but the most important thing. So generally, first thing which clicks in our mind is paisa. Like, paisa kahan se aayega? Paisa kahan hai? Kitna paisa chahiye? So money is the first thing which clicks our mind. And the second thing that comes in our mind is, ye paisa kahan se aayega? So when we talk about ye paisa kahan se aayega, so we think of banks, lenders, and sahukars. So hume lagta hai ki ye paisa yahan se aayega. So in economical terms, these are called market. Now, can you see the market picture? I have intentionally put the picture of agriculture mandi here. So in this, can anyone tell me what happens in agriculture mandi? Okay, let me explain. Here, farmers comes to sell their vegetables.
Sir, will you please repeat it? What was the question?
Okay, my question is, Are you able to see this market picture? It's a agriculture mandi. It's a vegetable. Sir. So, what happens in this mandi? Can anyone tell me?
Sir, someone buys product at cheap price and sell them at higher price.
Yeah, so in vegetable market, farmers comes to sell their vegetables, and then and the people come to buy the vegetables. So it's a place where farmers come to sell their vegetables and people come to buy their vegetables. So similarly, a market where rich people come to invest and needy people come to borrow. So that place is called a financial market. So today we will talk about the financial markets. So what will we learn today? These are the basic questions that we should know. So today we are learning about the financial markets. So from where this money comes? Ye paisa hame kahan se aata hai? Who takes this money? Who requires this money? Ye paisa kahan jayega? Place where money comes and goes. The place where this money comes and goes, usse kya kehte hain? What we call it? And who regulates this market? And what are the requirements to do these transactions? So we will mostly talk about the economical terms of these questions. So basically our topic is capital market. Now my flow of presentation will be, first I will try to explain what are the financial systems, what are the financial markets, and what are the types of financial markets. Then we will talk about deeply talk about the capital markets and its types, like primary capital market and secondary capital market. Then comes the interesting part, the what is the company and what are the types of company. I think this will be the most interesting part for you. And then we will talk about the shares, dividends, and then we will talk about what are the accounts required for dealing in shares. And then we will talk about the who are the people who invest in these companies. So type of investors, basically bull and bear. So you must have heard about the Harshad Mehta. So he is one of the bull investor. Then we will talk about the stock exchanges in India, BSE and NSE. And then finally, we will talk about the SEBI, who regulates this market. Now let's start with the financial systems. Suppose we have a elevated land, then the flow of water is from upper part to lower part, right? In the same way, when we talk about our economical system, so we have to ensure that the flow of finance should be from surplus sector to deficit sector. जिस तरीके से पानी ऊपर से नीचे की तरफ बहता है, इन अ सेम वे द मनी शुड फ्लो फ्रॉम सरप्लस सेक्टर टू डेफिसिट सेक्टर. सो दैट वी हैव टू एंश्योर. सो दैट टाइप ऑफ सिस्टम इज कॉल्ड फाइनेंशियल सिस्टम. एंड फाइनेंशियल मार्केट्स आर द मेन पार्ट ऑफ द फाइनेंशियल सिस्टम्स. दीज आर द स्मॉल पार्ट ऑफ फाइनेंशियल सिस्टम्स. So when we talk about financial markets, these are the small parts of financial systems, and systems should be in a way that surplus sector's money must come to the deficit sector. Now let's talk about the types of financial markets. Now we have learned that we need a money. When we require a money, we have to go to financial market. So sometimes we require a money for a very short time of period, and sometimes we require a money for a long period of time. So on the basis of that, on the basis of time, we have divided this financial markets into two markets. The first is a money market and the second is a capital market. When we require money for a short period of time, then we call it a money market. And when we require money for a longer period of time, then we call it a capital market. And now let's define the short term. The period up to 1 year is called a short period, and the period beyond 1 year is called a long term period. So that's how we define the financial markets in two parts. Now let's have an example of money market. Suppose our government requires some money for 7 days. Then they will issue a security, they will issue a financial instrument for a public so that they can get a money from public, and in return they have to pay the interest. Means government will pay the interest to the public because they are lending the money to the government. So that process is called at money at call. When we require money for a period of 1 to 14 days, then that process is called money at call. Means short term interest paying loan for 1 to 14 days. That is called a money at call. So this is a example of money market. So our today's topic is capital market. So we will mostly talk about the long term financial transactions. Suppose our government requires a money for a dam project. Then it requires a lot of money, and the government will not be able to pay that money within a year. So that type of requirement is called long-term requirement. Now the government will issue bonds, means the financial instruments. Now onwards, any financial instrument which is issued by any company, any government or any entity, we call it a security. Like share is a security, bond is a security, debenture is a security, money at call is a security. Now onwards we will call it a security. So that was the basic difference between money market and capital market. Money market is a short term financial transactions, and capital market is a long term financial transactions. And the examples are money at call for money market, and shares, bonds are example of capital market. Now let's move to the capital market, which is our today's topic. So again, we divide capital market into two parts. First is primary market and then secondary market. In primary market, suppose a company wants to offer a shares to the public. Let's assume we want to start a new business and we require a money. So we have a two options. Either we can invest our money or we can borrow a money. So generally companies, larger companies, borrows a money from the public. So suppose a company issues a share or issues a securities to the public. So this is called first sell in life of security. So market transactions will take place between issuer and investor. Means security will be sold in a primary market. Example like IPO. I think most of you have heard about this IPO. When a company offers their securities to the public for the first time, it is called IPO. So IPO is possible only once in the life of a company. If a company issues IPO, then it can not offer IPO again, because it will be called FPO. All offers to public after IPO is known as FPO, further public offering. So these are the markets where transactions happens between issuer and investors directly. It means we are not reselling the shares. We are directly purchasing the shares from the company. So that's why it is called primary market. And now let's come to the secondary market. It is a market where resale of securities happens means a company have already issued a share and that share is suppose that share is with me now I don't want to retain that share I want to sell this share to the third person then what I am doing I am reselling that share to the third person so it means resale of securities is happening so a market where resale of securities happens that market is called secondary market it means the transaction will happen between two investors that is obvious so whatever the transactions we see in stock exchanges are called secondary market so basically there are two types of capital market primary market and secondary market the basic difference is the new security when the company issues new securities then it is called primary market when resale of securities happen then it is called secondary market that is the basic difference now let's come to the most important part that is company so what do you understand by company can anyone tell me yeah can anyone explain what is company or what do you understand by company
sir any business oriented firm
yeah anyone else
a group or association of people
yeah correct so company is the biggest form of business organizations suppose we want to start a business and I am the only person who is interested in the business so I am what we call it I am the proprietor of that company means we cannot call it a company because you are a single proprietor so when we want to do a business at a larger scale then we need a bigger business organization and that business organization is called company so as we have already studied that when we want to start a business we require money to establish a company and to operate the company so the money that is required to establish a company and to operate the company is called capital so in economic terms we call it a capital so when we require a money we have two options either a owner can invest money in that company or a company can borrow money from others so these are the two options so let's take the owner's capital when a owner itself gives a money to a company then that money is called a share capital means owner's capital is also known as share capital now for ease of transactions that share capital is divided into small denominations suppose we are investing 10 crore rupees now I want to say that this is my part means I have invested 10% in the company so that 10% is my share so that's why one part of that share capital is known as share so every person who purchases a share is known as shareholder now you have bought a share now you know share capital now you know capital share now you are a shareholder at the end of financial year a company will get a profit now you have a right to get the part of your profit in the ratio of your share and that part is known as dividend means every shareholder has a right to get his part of profit so that part of a profit is known as dividend So that was a definition of a company shares, share capital and dividend. Now let's study what are the type of companies. Basically in India, we divide companies into three parts: public limited company, private limited company and government company. So anyone can tell me the difference between these three? No. Can anyone differentiate between these three, public, private, and government company? It's a very simple question, but there must be a logic behind it.
Private are those, the full ownership of the company is on the proprietor or promoter, and in government companies 50, more than 50% hold the government, and in public limited companies there are some shares on the promoters of the company and maximum on the public.
Okay, you are very near to the answer, but let me explain. First thing, that government company is a company in which government holds minimum 50% or more than 50% share, then that company will be called government company. Like I am working in a Hindustan Petroleum. It's a government company because government holds more than 50% of share in Hindustan Petroleum. So it is also known as public sector enterprise, and the other name is public sector unit, PSUs or PSEs. And if a company is of central government, then it is called CPSE, Central Public Enterprises. So that is a government company. Now, what is the basic difference between public and private limited company? If a company is listed on a stock exchange and a company can issue shares to the public, then that company will be called public limited company. And a company which cannot issue shares to the public, that company will be called private limited company. So that is the basic difference. Actually, there are lots of other points there, but the basic difference comes from this part only, from the issues, from the issue of securities to the public. So that is the basic difference. If you can issue the securities to the public, then it is called a public limited company. And if you cannot issue shares to the public, then it will be a private limited company. So these are the basic three types of companies. Now, on the basis of shareholders' liability, have you heard about that limited company and unlimited company? Like we call it Tata Limited. So what do you understand by limited word in that? Can anyone tell me what does limited means in that private limited company?
No idea about it, sir.
Okay. So actually, suppose you have taken a 20% share of Hindustan Petroleum. Now you are an owner of a company. But suppose a situation comes when a company is bankrupt. Now the company will recover the money from the shareholders. If you have subscribed at 20% shares of a company, then your liability is to pay a 20% value of that shares. मतलब अगर आपने 100 रुपए के शेयर खरीदे हैं तो आपको 100 रुपए ही कंपनी को वापस चुकाना है अगर आप लिमिटेड कंपनी में हैं. इट मींस मैक्सिमम लायबिलिटी ऑफ शेयर होल्डर इज फिक्स्ड. दैट्स व्हाई वी यूज लिमिटेड कंपनी एट द एंड ऑफ द नेम ऑफ द कंपनी. एंड इफ इट इज अनलिमिटेड कंपनी देन लायबिलिटी ऑफ शेयर होल्डर इज नॉट फिक्स्ड. मतलब अगर आपने 100 रुपए के शेयर खरीदे हैं और कंपनी को 1000 रुपए चाहिए तो आपके जितने भी प्रॉपर्टी है तो कंपनी विल सेल ऑल योर असेट्स एंड रिकवर द मनी. दैट इज कॉल्ड अनलिमिटेड कंपनी. मींस लायबिलिटी ऑफ शेयर होल्डर इज नॉट फिक्स्ड. सो दैट्स व्हाई जनरली कंपनीज आर लिमिटेड कंपनीज बिकॉज द मैक्सिमम लायबिलिटी ऑफ शेयर होल्डर इज फिक्स्ड इन द कंपनी. सो दैट इज द बेसिक डिफरेंस बिटवीन लिमिटेड एंड अनलिमिटेड कंपनी. Now we have learnt about the company. Now we have learnt about the shares. Now we know the type of companies. Now we want to buy a share in the market. Then we require some accounts to deal with the shares. So I'll tell you one by one what are the accounts which we require to deal in shares. The first thing that we require is a bank account. That is a normal saving account which we all have. After that, we need a DMAT account. I think most of you have heard about DMAT account.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So actually in 1990s, shares were in paper form. Means we had to buy shares in a paper form and had to submit those shares in an account. So that was means what does it mean? It means the shares were in a material form. But now you can see we can transact shares online also. So what we have done? We have dematerialized the shares. Means we are trading online now. Now we do not have shares in paper form. So that process is called dematerialization. And the account which is required to buy a share and to deposit a share is called DMAT account. Now, normal saving account can be opened by going into the any branch of any bank, but DMAT account can be opened with the help of some organizations. These organizations are known as depository, like NSDL and CDSL. These are the organizations which opens your account to deposit shares. So NSDL, National Security Depository Limited, it is an organization by National Stock Exchange. It was established in 1996. Similarly, Bombay Stock Exchange also have a depository named as CDSL, Central Depository Services Limited. So if you want to deal in a share, then you can open your account by using these depositories. Means you have to approach the depository if you want to open a DMAT account, and if you want to open a saving account, then you have to go to bank. In the same way, if you want to transact, so now what you have done, you have deposited a share, but now you want to make transactions of those shares. Means you want to sell and purchase shares. For that, you need another account. That account is called trading account, and that can be opened with the help of share broker. So the account which is required to deposit a share is called DMAT account, and the account which is required to transact a shares in the share market is called trading accounts. So these are the basic three accounts which are required for dealing in shares. So now we know company, now we know shares, now we know share capital, now we know the dividend, now we know type of companies, now we are clear about the accounts required for dealing in shares. And we are talking about the capital markets. Initially we talked that rich person will come to invest their money. So now we will study about type of investors. So जिनके पास पैसा ज्यादा है वो आएगा और उसको इंटरेस्ट लेगा और जाएगा, एंड जिसके पास पैसा नहीं है वो वहां आएगा, पैसा लेगा और वापस जाएगा. इट मीन्स नीडी पर्सन विल कम टू अ कैपिटल मार्केट एंड विल बोरो द मनी एंड पे द इंटरेस्ट एंड विल गो आउट. इन द सेम वे रिच पर्सन विल कम टू द मार्केट, ही विल इन्वेस्ट द मनी, ही विल टेक द इंटरेस्ट एंड गो आउट. So on the basis of that, we have a two types of investors. First is real investors and second is speculators. What is the basic difference between these two? So the basic difference is the real investors are those investors, those people who want to maintain some share ratio in a company, or you can say they want to invest for a long term. They want a decision power in their hand. They want to control the company. Dealing in a shares is not their main activity. Means they don't want a short term profit. They want a long term profit. Like if we take an example of Mukesh Ambani, he has a long-term interest in Reliance Industries. And if he is transacting shares in HPCLs, then that will be a short-term interest. Means he wants to earn a money from speculations of the share market. So he does not have an interest in the HPCL. He has an interest in the Reliance Industries. So there his long-term interest is in the Reliance Industries. So he is a real investor in Reliance Industries and he is a speculator in a Hindustan Petroleum. So that is the basic difference between the real investors and speculators. Deal in a shares and they do not have a interest in controlling the main activities of a company. They have a short-term transactions, means they deal in short-term transactions. And on the basis of that, we have a two types of speculators, bull and bear. We usually see these pictures, bull and bear. And whenever we talk about the share market, we always talk about the bull and bear. Right? So have you heard of Harshad Mehta?
Yes, sir.
So Harshad Mehta deals in a short-term transactions. He is a speculator and he is a bull speculator. Now let me explain you what is the difference between bull and bear. Suppose maine 100 rupees ka share purchase kiya and then I anticipated that my share price will increase, so I purchased it at a rate of 100 and then after 3 or 4 days, I sold it at a rate of 120 rupees. So I got a profit of 20 rupees. So what does it mean? It means I anticipated the rise in the market. Agar share market badh raha hai, to main usme invest kar raha hun, then it is called a bull speculator. So Harshad Mehta is a perfect example of bull speculator. He always anticipate in the rise in the market. On the other hand, a person who anticipate downfall in the market is called a bear speculator. Means agar share price gir raha hai, then I am investing. Suppose 100 rupees ka share tha, uske baad mujhe malum hai, I know that the price of a share will decrease to 80 rupees. So I will not purchase the share at a rate of 100 rupees. I will purchase the share on a later time when it will become of rupees 80. जब 80 रुपए का हो जाएगा तब मैं उस शेयर को खरीदूंगा. मतलब क्या हुआ कि 100 रुपए का तो मैं अभी बेच दूंगा किसी को. आई विल सेल दैट शेयर एट अ प्राइस ऑफ 100 रुपीज एंड आई विल परचेज इट एट अ लेटर स्टेज एट अ प्राइस ऑफ 80 रुपीज. सो दैट इज द बेसिक डिफरेंस बिटवीन बुल एंड बियर. मीन्स हु इन्वेस्टर हु एंटिसिपेट राइज इन द मार्केट इज कॉल्ड अ बुल स्पेकुलेटर एंड द इन्वेस्टर हु एक्सपेक्ट डाउनफॉल इन द मार्केट इज नोन एज बियर स्पेकुलेटर. Now we have talked about the capital markets. A capital market is a place where rich comes to invest and needy comes to borrow. So what is the, can anyone tell me the best example of capital market? Can anyone tell example of capital market? In India,
BSE, NSE.
Yeah. So, when you talk about the stock exchanges in India, these are the capital markets where the people comes to invest and people come to borrow. So, those are called stock exchanges of India. These are called also known as capital markets of India. Now let's talk about the Bombay Stock Exchange. So Bombay Stock Exchange was established in 1875. And you will be happy to know that this is the oldest exchange of Asia. And it is among the five biggest exchanges of the world also. So Bombay and its headquarters is situated in Mumbai. And have you heard of Sensex and Nifty? These are the basic. Yeah, these are the basic financial instruments which we oftenly see in newspapers and in TV also. So, now you know what is the Bombay Stock Exchange. What is the purpose of Bombay Stock Exchange? It is a market where transactions of shares will happen, or you can say transactions of securities will happen at stock exchanges. Now, Bombay Stock Exchange. If हमने कभी कभी सुना है कि आज stock exchange गिर गया, what does it mean?
जो top companies होती हैं उनके shares down हो जाएं.
Yeah. So, let's take an example of Bombay Stock Exchange. The main index of this stock exchange is Sensex. Sensex means sensitivity index. In this index, there are 30 companies of India which are enlisted on this stock exchange. And if a company is performing well, then the share price of that company will increase. And it means the share value, your market capitalization of that company will increase. So Sensex will also increase. So what we can say, if Sensex is falling down, it means the companies which are enlisted on Sensex are not performing well. And if Sensex is going up, it means the companies enlisted on that, on the Bombay Stock Exchange are performing well. So that's how Sensex works on the Bombay Stock Exchange. So it indicates performance of all shares or the performance of a company. So the main index of Bombay Stock Exchange is Sensex. It has other indexes also, but those are not so popular. BSE 100, BSE 200 are also the other indexes of Bombay Stock Exchange. But these are not so popular because these are 100 companies are enlisted in this Sensex index, but these are not so popular because top 30 companies of India are enlisted in Sensex only. So if these companies are performing well, the Sensex is going up, and if these are not performing Well, then the Sensex will go down. Now let's move to the NSE. NSE is also a part of a capital market. It is similar as a Bombay Stock Exchange, but it was established in 1992. Its headquarters is also in Mumbai, and it is the second biggest exchange in India after Bombay Stock Exchange. And the main index of this stock exchange is Nifty. Nifty's full form is National Index of 50 Companies. Means this index was given by S&P Nifty, so Standard and Poor Company. So it is also known as S&P Nifty. So in this index, top 50 companies of India are enlisted. So if these companies are performing well, then the National Stock Exchange will go up, and if they are not performing well, then the National Stock Exchange will go down, or Nifty will go up, or Nifty will go down. Till now we have studied about the stock exchanges, capital market, companies, investors. Now the most important thing is the SEBI. Means जब हम घर में होते हैं तो हमारे घर में पापा क्या करते हैं, हमें कंट्रोल करते हैं कि ऐसा करना है, ऐसा नहीं करना है. So in the same way, when you want to regulate a capital market, you need a papa, and that papa is known as SEBI, Security and Exchange Board of India. So it was established in 1988, and the parliament passed the SEBI Act in 1992. So this organization was formed by a law. That's why it is called a statutory body. And its main function is to regulate the security market, or you can say financial market in India. Now let's study what are the basic functions of this SEBI. So the first thing that it does is it makes the rules relating to security market, ताकि हमारे साथ धोखा ना हो. अगर हम shares में deal कर रहे हैं, अगर dealing in shares, तो हमारे साथ fraud ना हो, उसके लिए SEBI makes the rules. That is the first and the most important work of SEBI. And the second work is ensure effective implementation of these rules. Now, suppose we have made a rule, but no one is following, then what is the use of those rules? That's why SEBI ensures the effective implementation of those rules. And if someone is non-complying it, then SEBI enforces penalties also. And suppose share broker or shareholder ke beech mein kuch dispute ho gaya, then what will happen? Then SEBI will come into the picture and he will readdress the dispute. And it also protect the interest of investors also. Means it will work for investors, because investors are the most important part of capital market. And it provide licenses to stock exchanges. Suppose we want to make a new stock exchanges, then SEBI has the authority to provide licenses to the exchanges and to the credit rating agencies. Like we always see that S&P rating, CRISIL rating, these are the agencies which provide ratings to the companies on their performances. So SEBI provide licenses to these agencies also. So these are the basic functions of SEBI. Now let's come to the last slide, what we have learned today. The first thing which we learned, that ki paisa kahan se aayega, investors market mein aayenge, and who will take this money, borrower jo jinko zarurat hai, those people who need a money will come to the market, so those are called borrowers. And the place where money comes and goes is called financial market, like in India BSE, NSE. And then we saw who regulates this market. So SEBI regulates that market. Now what are the requirements to do the transactions? So we saw that we require a 3 accounts to deal in shares. Then we learned about the economical terms like company, shares, dividend and IPO. So that's it from my side. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir, for giving us a wonderful presentation. We learned many things from it. So we can start up now. So now we can start up with the question answers round. So any of you who are having any questions which is related to the presentation given by sir, you may turn on your mic and ask the question to sir, or you may also leave your question in the chat box.
Hello.
Yeah.
Bia, I have a question for you. Can I ask?
Yeah. Sure.
Bia, you said that after you BTEC, you cleared CAT exam and your PPT showed that your mindset is all about running any startup or any business. Then why are you choosing a political science career and from a IGNU? Can you tell me about this something?
Yeah. Actually, it depends on your interest, your mindset. If you have a mindset of doing anything, then that thing will be very easier for you. If you think that I cannot do this thing, then your mindset will be different. Means you will face many problems. ऐसा लगेगा जैसे मुझे करना ही नहीं है, मुझे ऐसा नहीं करना है. So it's not about what I am doing actually. It's all about the interest. If you have an interest in the political science, then yeah, you should do that.
Right now, Bia, are you engaged in any business or startup or willing to start any?
Yeah, actually, presently, last year, I opened a small petrol pump for me. So that's the business I have currently.
So what's the difference between small cap and mid cap companies?
Yeah, I'll explain. Suppose you have a small company and whose market capitalization value is a small, means you are dealing in a shares with a limited number of shares and the value of shares are very small, then market capitalization value of your company will come very low. And if you have a high value of shares, then market capitalization value of your company will relatively high. So it depends on the outstanding shares or the value of the shares of your company. So generally small cap companies lies between 300 million to 2 billion. And if you have a market capitalization value of greater than 2 billion, then it is called a mid cap companies.
Thank you, Bia.
Hello.
Yeah.
Am I audible?
Yeah.
Yes, I also have a question. So, since your presentation is most about marketing and startups, so what really motivated you to do this kind of work? Like, did our college help you, or is there any some experience you want to share regarding this?
So you want to listen my experience, or what should I say?
Sir, like your point of view, like what really motivated you?
Actually, the most important thing is the management actually. Yeah, we know that we have done an engineering, we are doing an engineering, but engineering gives you a technical excellence. But we should understand what does management means and what are good managers. If you will know about it, then it will be really helpful for you. Suppose a good manager is a person who optimally utilizes the resources. who knows how to manage the time, how to reduce the cost, and how to manage the human resources. So these are the important things which we should know. So once you know these qualities, you will be a good manager. But to acquire these qualities, you need a management course and you need a management qualities. So these management qualities comes from two things. First is from experience, and the other is from learning, like from IIMs and all. So I'll say, if we reduce management from anything, it will become zero. And means we have done an engineering, but 1% of the engineers will become good managers. So management and doing management is a very important thing for every one of us. So I will suggest each one of you that we should go for management degree, and we should know how a good manager works. Lalu Yadav ke bare mein suna hai? Lalu Yadav?
Yes, we are.
Lalu Yadav ne bola tha ki achha gwala wo hai jo matlab gaay se ek boond bhi doodh usme na chode, pura ka pura doodh bahar nikal le. So that is a good manager. फिर उसने क्या किया, ट्रेन में वही ट्रेन चलती थी, उसी ट्रेन में एक एक्स्ट्रा सीट लगा दिया, उसने कॉस्ट को रिड्यूस किया. सो दैट्स अ क्वालिटी ऑफ अ गुड मैनेजर. सो इन माय ओपिनियन, एवरी स्टूडेंट शुड डू मैनेजमेंट कोर्स एंड शुड लर्न मैनेजमेंट क्वालिटीज. देन योर पर्सपेक्टिव विल चेंज, देन योर थिंकिंग प्रोसेस विल चेंज, देन यू विल कम टू नो, ओ now we have a excellence in engineering, but managing engineers is the best part. Means when you will join a company, you will be managed by a manager. Now you have experience in an engineering field, but at a later time you have to manage the engineers. So but you need that quality for that. So I'll suggest to do a management course. Means we should go for a CAT also. Then our perspective will change. Yeah.
Okay, sir. What should be the investing strategies for the beginners? Should we go for the long term or short term or just intraday?
Actually, it depends on your financial, mental, and your environmental positions. Actually sab cheezon ko dekh ke chalna chahiye. Suppose I belong to a farmer's family, then I know that I do not have a sufficient money to start a new business. So there are lots of factors which we should consider before starting a new business. So I'll suggest that agar paisa hai और पहले से आपके पास बिजनेस है, देन इट्स योर चॉइस. फर्स्ट यू शुड एक्सेल द मैनेजमेंट स्किल्स एंड देन यू शुड गो फॉर अ बिजनेस.
सुंदर पिचाई आल्सो डिड मैनेजमेंट फ्रॉम अदर यूनिवर्सिटीज बिफोर गोइंग टू गूगल.
या सो आई विल टेल यू, if you will see the Times of India survey, among all CEOs, 70% have done management course before becoming a CEO. So yeah, that's why I mean management course is very important.
So we have one more question.
Yeah.
Have you faced any problem when you were starting your business, mini petrol pump, and from where you raise your fund, from your family or from your market, anywhere?
Yeah, actually, it was a small business. I invested 2 crore rupees in that. So part of that money I have got from market, and part of the money is from my family side. So it's obvious. It was very difficult for me to start that type of business because it was really a risky business, and we required a lot of money, and then we required a lot of approvals from government departments, and you know what is the position of our government departments. So I faced many difficulties to start that business, but finally now fruits have come. So I'll suggest that take risk, but thoda dhyan se.
Hello,
sir.
Yeah,
sir. How should we prepare our portfolio? What should be the point we should consider while making a portfolio?
Portfolio for what? For which field?
So you are not audible.
I'm asking portfolio for what? What do you want to do?
Sir, for stock market.
Okay. So it's a very big question actually. It's not that simple as it looks. Because now, have you heard about the mutual funds?
Yes, sir.
You know, yes, they are collecting the money from the people and then they are investing money in different companies. And they have a very good experts. So it's really difficult to say that which portfolio we should choose actually, because no one is sure that what will happen in the share market. So it's really a difficult question that which portfolio we should go for. If you want to make a portfolio, then you can choose for a mutual fund.
Yes, sir, there are not as good returns we can expect.
Sorry? Good networks? What?
Good returns, sir.
No. If you'll go in a mutual funds, you will get at least 10 to 15% returns, and that's a very good return.
But sir, in a stock market, we can get more than that.
Yeah. In stock market, you can get more than that, but you have a greater risk in that.
Yes.
You have a probability of losing money also. You have a higher probability of losing money in share market. So it's all about risk.
But sir, many times if the share market is going down, then mutual funds will also not give that much return.
But yeah, investing for a long period of time means for at least for a three to five years period of time, then you will get a good return.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
So
there was one question about the.
Yes, sir.
There was one more thing about the social media handles of the Anurag. You might know who have the access.
Anurag social media.
Yes, sir. Facebook and Instagram.
Yeah. So, what do you want to know?
Sir, we want to. Sir, we don't have the access to them. There are handles.
So you want to know whether we have access of Facebook and Twitter?
Yes,
handles?
Sir.
No, currently we do not have any access to Facebook and Twitter handles of Anurag.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
So, am I audible?
Yeah.
So there are some questions which have been put by the students in the chat box. So, sir, first question has been asked by Kotni Chaitanya. He's asking, sir, can I know an advantage of buying an IPO?
Yeah. Abhi, IPO, just have you heard about that Reliance deal? IPO mein actually hota ye hai ki IPO jab koi company nikalti hai, when a company offers an IPO, it means ki the value of shares will definitely increase. To pehle hi log IPO ke shares ko pehle hi khareed liya jata hai. Aur Reliance ki deal mein aap dekhoge, if you see the Reliance deal, then 80 times means number of applications were 80 times of the shares available. So it's very clear that IPO, if you are purchasing shares in IPO, then it's really advantageous.
Sir, lekin abhi do teen company jab listing mein aaye to uske IPO ka price ghat gaya sir, do teen times sir.
ऐसा जनरली होता है, द कंपनीज विच आर नॉट सो पॉपुलर और विच आर परफॉर्मिंग वेल, उनके साथ ऐसा होता है जनरली. बट इफ यू इन्वेस्ट इन अ वेरी गुड कंपनी लाइक रिलायंस, लाइक ONGC एंड ऑल, देन इट विल डेफिनेटली गिव यू रिटर्न.
ओके.
So the next question has been put up by Saurav Kumar. Sir, he is asking, what is the future of cryptos in India?
Cryptocurrency, that's a separate topic actually. So the current position is government is thinking about it. It's not legal in India, but government will take the decision. So we cannot comment on it.
Okay, sir. So as a host, I also have a question to you.
Yeah.
As you were one of the founding member of Anubrat, so what were your vision for this club and what were your initial thoughts for the future of the club?
Yeah, it's a good question actually. When we started this club, we were in a very initial position actually. Kuch bhi nahi tha. Us campus mein kuch bhi nahi tha. Companies which were coming in our campus were very limited. And then we visited IIT Guwahati, then we visited IIT Kharagpur, NIT Durgapur, NIT Agartala, NIT Silchar. Then we came to know that ki aisa platform jab hota hai, then we can get an access to the good companies. Means like companies like HPCL, ONGC and other PSUs, unka dhyan rehta hai. They have a presence in the companies, in the college societies and all. So it's a platform which can be used to invite companies, which can be used to to popularize our college, and isse kya hai, it will help you to increase the interaction between students. You will come to know about the outside world, what is happening in other colleges, because once you start this society, you have to face a competition. You will organize a fest, then you have to compete with others. And then you will get a very good experience, and you अच्छा रहेगा, मतलब काफी अच्छा and popular होगा, और इससे अपने बच्चों को means the students will get the most benefit of it. और reason
thank you,
ये था हम लोगों
का. भैया वाला question, ये question. I'm from the Tripoli branch.
Okay.
So you are running a petrol pump based organization, then you will see that after 5 to 6 years, there is a lots of electrical car in the market.
Yeah.
And your source of income will decline over a period of time. So we are resilient say aapko dar nahi laga?
Like
Tesla is using their electrified cars, scooter.
Yeah. I am in a Hindustan Petroleum Corporation Limited company. It's also a energy company. So we have done a study of electric vehicles. So India will take at least 20 years जो कि मतलब लोगों के अंदर आ सकेगी, मतलब गाड़ियां आ सकेंगी, इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल्स जो रूरल में पहुंच सकेंगी, शहरों में आ सकेंगी. सो इट विल टेक एटलीस्ट 20 ईयर्स टाइम एंड इट्स रियली डिफिकल्ट टू बिल्ड इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर फॉर इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल्स. एंड ऑन द अदर हैंड जो इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल्स के चार्जिंग स्टेशन है, चार्जिंग स्टेशन ऑफ दिस इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल्स आर ऑल्सो being built up on petrol pumps, वहीं पर लगाए जा रहे हैं वो. So उससे कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ेगा, I don't think so. And the number of vehicles are increasing day by day. So the demand of petrol is still increasing. And according to our study, it will increase up to next 20 to 30 years.
Okay,
and thank you so much, sir. So we are having in this meet, so Hemant sir is also present. So now I would like to invite him to say something.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hi, sir.
Hi, hello, Paras. How are you?
Fine, sir. Fine, fine, sir. बहुत अच्छा लगा sir after a long period of time.
Very good, very good, very good. So. So actually, I have something to ask, like, right? So regarding this Anuvart, like before that, you guys used to handle this Facebook page.
Okay.
So if anybody has the access of this Anuvart Facebook page, if you can give the some password or something, if you guys have something to, you know, some password or something, maybe you can ask you some other.
Sir, I'll ask the seniors. Actually, they must have the password of Facebook actually, so I'll ask and I'll let you know.
Yeah. And apart from this, is very good actually you have given the time to the all the students, and I hope all the students got some kind of information about the share market and management and business and all those things. If anybody having a some kind of interest in future, so they can take a lot of advantage. So
sure.
Okay, Paras, from my side. Okay, again, thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you from my side also. Thank you, everyone.
Hello.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. So I guess if any of the audience who are having questions, can I guess mail you, sir? You can provide your email ID.
Yeah, I'll send. I'm writing in the chat box.
So on behalf of Anuvart, I would like to thank you, sir, for providing your gracious presence to join us today to enhance our joy, and also our audience. Thank you so much, everyone, for joining us. And with this, we come to the end of the program.
Thank you.